Hi everybody, welcome back to In the Kingdom. Today I just want to share a quick story with you, and one of the things that I want to adjust before judgment, I want to make sure that I am always about my Father's business. Whenever Yeshua was left behind and his mom and Joseph were looking for him, and he said in Luke 2:49, he says, "Why did you seek me? Did you not know that I must be about my Father's business?" That is something I want to make sure I am doing in this next year. I don't want to miss any opportunity to witness to somebody. I want to be about the kingdom building business with my life in everywhere. When I'm in the store, when I'm out to eat, when I'm playing with my kids somewhere, if there's an opportunity, I want to be able to see it. And with that, I want to share a dream that one of my pastors shared. I can't remember if it was her dream. I think it was a dream she had seen of some other pastor. But in the dream, this pastor was in heaven and he was seeing all these faces. He was like, "Oh, I know that person," and excited to see faces from his congregation there in heaven. But then he started noticing that they were looking at him angry. And he was like, "Why are they looking at me so angry?" And then he realized that these people weren't making it into heaven. And they were angry with him because he had missed telling them something. Or maybe he didn't reveal the gospel, the entire gospel to them. And so when they came and stood before the judge on the Day of Atonement, they were short. Their names were not written in the Lamb's Book of Life. And my pastor said, "You know, that has haunted me. I don't ever want somebody that was in my congregation that I did not pull out all the stops and let them know the whole Word of God, the whole counsel of the Word of God, so that when I stand before the judge, I can hear, 'Well done,' you know, that she gave it her best, that whenever she spoke to somebody, she held nothing back, so that there would be no cause for them to look at her that way on the Day of Judgment." And that, when she shared that story, that has haunted me. I don't want somebody that has ever crossed my path and I missed the opportunity to witness to them, and then for me to watch that person one day, knowing I had the opportunity to reach them, watch them walk past and look at me like, "Why didn't you tell me? Why didn't you share this with me, the whole counsel of God?" And so that is what I try to do, and that is what I'm working on, something I want to keep adjusting until the Day of Judgment, that I keep adjusting, keep looking for those opportunities to reach other people. I pray you are blessed. We only have a few more days left in this 40 days of preparation, so I will see you tomorrow. Bye.